Here we are at Bridge Cottage on a Monday, the 20th of October, and that chap there carrying his two packages there is, I think, one of the archaeologists from London. He's going to be doing some dating work for us today.
Yeah, this one's signals.
It's just from there.
It's a bit of iron, it's very close to the surface. I should think it's just on the flag.
The thing about magnetic dating is you have to physically take the material away. Sure. So it means you have a lovely hearth, we're going to have to try and pry out some of the tiles and things so that they can go and be dated. We're using archaeomagnetic dating techniques, which when the material is being burnt to quite a high temperature, it kind of resets the particles, the iron particles within the material, and as it cools, they take on the alignment with the Earth's current magnetic field. So what we do is we set up a gyro theodolite, which we use to work out and sort of where true north is, and then we'll glue little buttons onto the areas that we want to take samples from. We have to make sure that they're horizontal, and then we mark them up with the readings that we've got from our gyro theodolite, lift the material, and then it gets sent off to the University of Bradford, who demagnetise it and then compare the results with it's like a big curve. So all the data from all previous archaeomagnetic sites is sort of, you know, amalgamated, and we should be able to work out the date that it cooled down in.
Amazing. What sort of accuracy can you predict?
It depends, I think, sort of at the when it cooled. And it also depends on how active the magnetic field was at the time. So if there wasn't much movement for, say, a couple of hundred years, you're not going to be able to refine the date more than that. But I think the period we're looking at here, if I remember rightly, you can get a date to within sort of 50 to 100 years.
Oh, wow.
Sometimes it's better, and as you get closer, as you're combining the magnetic data with like scientific reading.
Being a layman, what does it mean after that to this place?
You should give you a date for when that hearth was last used, basically.
Right.
So it's the last time that it was heated up above a certain temperature.
There it is, you know, some of the chalk doesn't get burned, it's not crushed down enough, it just gets in the mix. I think anybody who's too sort of put that in a cooking mix now.
But got a really big stone in there.
Right.
So you've got two, but he stayed at one or two.
That's definitely stepped up, hasn't it? Look down there.
Yeah.
I've got a look at the surface underneath to see.
Actually getting some pottery out of one of these layers.
Oh, fantastic.
Which are abutting the early wall or this new wall.
Right.
Yeah. So if we get some rim out or some decent bit of base, it'll be dated. It may be datable already because we've got two sorts of pot represented.
There's an example right there of ceramic bits they're picking up. which they think predates the 1436 house. So that hearth has been totally covered up now, obviously preserved, and this whole area, this whole floor is going to be built up to make the new floor. These show the various levels which make up the floor. There'll be some insulation, and you can see some glass, some sand, and then the top line represents the top of the floor, the new floor that's going down. So everything you can see down there on the floor there will be covered up. This stone here represents the outer wall of the 1436 building.